Sundance Helicopters. This is an abandoned hotel. Or maybe it's not abandoned, just looks abandoned. Yeah, it's right in front of Sundance. Like an RV parking area. Apartments in the back behind the tower. And there's the venue. Fuel tanks in the back. Right? These bus drivers are crazy. Gunpowder. So, again, that one single bullet strike shooting from up there. Not yet. See all those patches with black marks? More bullet strike cover-ups, where all the black squares are. Impossible to get over that wall. So there's no sign of anything along this. You know, there's some holes here and there, but a lot of times they patch signs and such to the wall. Came in, said it was really loud where she was at. Here towards the fuel tank, where Melissa Ramirez was left to die. Care tops. isn't it? For the Luxor? The helicopter concept. Yeah, there are a lot of helicopters that fly around here. But other than news choppers, I have yet to see one hover in one spot. Like we saw between the Delano and the Mandalay Bay, you had three of them hovering in that area during the shooting. So unless there were news and filming, government and filming, somebody else was not doing what they should have been doing. Alright, we're going to walk towards the fuel tank. Give you an idea where we're at. That's where Tall Ace of Spades started recording. Gate 7, which there was a call from. So this is quite a distance to walk to where Melissa Ramirez was left to die. So, can't imagine carrying somebody that great of a distance. Distance it would be to carry her all this way. And passing cops and ambulances along the way, people in trucks that could have carried her to the ambulance or to the hospital or to an ambulance. Bumpy, rocky terrain. Which is a challenge to walk across. This is when you're walking on your own. Couldn't imagine running across this stuff. It's very uneven. And very rocky. We got some advertising trucks sitting over here. This is where they take their break. People couldn't imagine why people would jump this fence to the church when, if they ran this way, there's a gap in the fence back there, but it's a very small gap, as you will see. We're going to take a look at this fence, or this wall, I should say, because if he was able to shoot from way over there, we might have a bullet strike in this wall. And we're gonna walk up this way a little bit. Don't see anything. There's a that footage. Definitely could have jumped this fence. Especially if he would have came to the corner right here. Just kind of use that as leverage. Looking for bullet strike. Came out this far past across his dirt lot, he really got trapped. He either had to jump this fence to go into the church parking lot, which goes all the way around up to right in front of gate 6, or he would have had to come across this way, and over there on that side of the fence, it's all fenced off, blocked off the fuel tank. And then there's just a small opening. Small opening. But I can imagine that if everyone was running this direction, they would have hit that fence on both sides. They would have had no other option but to go through this opening. And this wall, there's no bullet strike. This is a small opening. Looks like it's maybe 2 feet, 2-3 feet wide. So everyone would have had to funnel right through this little opening. And then this is where Melissa Ramirez lost her last breath. So they would have come across here. Kind of weird because you would have came like straight across this direction, right by this fire hydrant. Godspeed. Rest in peace, sweetheart. So, over here is where we've got a bullet strike, which seems pretty impossible and quite the distance. Because this Mandalay Bay, the angle of it, something and ricocheted up here. So if it hit over here somewhere, we would have a ricochet mark, bullet strike on the ground, which I do not see. So it would have been like this, from like this angle, to hit that door so fleshly. Almost with the door. around that church to hide it either. Anyway, well, I'm going to go for now. It's getting dark. Bye, guys.